Chester, listen, I asked Nate. I went over there today, and he said no. Well, he didn't actually say no, actually. Like, I got there, and then there was a sign on the door, and it said, "Heard you were coming, left town," and then I saw a sold sign on the front lawn, so
I got there, and I got to the house, I knocked on the door, and it wasn't Nate, it was some random stranger. Apparently, they're the new owners of the house. They said that the buyers left in a hurry, and they didn't really say anything, except they just said, like, they were screaming Periwinkle as they drove away, so that's a good thing, right? But anyways, he can't take us. He's long gone. He's off the grid. We don't know where he went. So honestly, I don't know how we're going to get to camp anymore.
I don't know how we're going to get there. Because we've asked everyone, Chester. We've asked everyone. And they all said no.
There's no one left. We asked every single leader except for Strom, which he doesn't hang out with anyone. He doesn't, barely shows up. So I can't get a hold of him, but anyways, I don't think we can go.
What do you mean you can take us? I don't know how that's possible. You're a turkey.
Chester, you know I'm ticklish, but no, you can't. You're an inanimate object. There is no way you can take us to camp. What do you mean you have a car? What do you mean it's over there?
Where? It's right over.
Is that your car? Alright, I mean, let's go. I guess we can go.
Chester, we're gonna see how this goes. We're gonna
come on, Chester, come on. Let's get this show on the road. It's getting dark.
Now looking back at my time and my efforts going to wildlife camp. I'm sorry, I got thirsty for a moment there, but back to my story. I decided to write my own novel about my adventures and Chester's adventures as well. You may notice the ring on my finger, and at wildlife camp I got married to my beloved Helga. At 13 years old. But that's a different story. Anyways, after time and time again of being turned down by every wildlife leader and not being able to find one wildlife leader, Tyler Strom, I finally found a way to get to wildlife camp, and I found it in my best friend Chester. And we drove off and crashed into a ditch. And a kind man helped me out, but we got there, and we had the time of our life. I met Helga, I bonded with my best friend Chester, and we spent numerous months at wildlife camp until people actually showed up. I don't even know why I have a pipe in my mouth currently, because I'm asthmatic, and it doesn't make any sense, because I can't actually smoke it, because I'll have an asthma attack. But anyways, that's my story. And it was the best week of my life.